walking the Camino is a replication of the pilgrim's journey that many people did over thousands and thousands of years and are still doing today. The original pilgrims went in search of the remains of St. James, who was one of the apostles of Jesus Christ. And the whole pilgrimage journey was about forgiving self for sins, a ritual of cleansing, a return to the church, a return to ideals. I think everybody that does the Camino does it for different reasons. My reason for doing it is something I've always wanted to do without really knowing why, something of a personal challenge. Can I walk that far? But there's also a growing sense in me as I've made this choice to spontaneously take this trip with like 3 to 4 weeks preparation. There's a growing sense for me of walking with Our Lady. And I did grow up in the Catholic Church. I went to a convent girls' school. I would say I'm a lapsed Catholic because I know the Catholic Church, whilst it's done much good in the world, has also created a lot of rules and rigidity that I found out of alignment with heart energy. So for me, I am looking forward to seeing Fatima, which is where the apparition of Our Lady, where she appeared to the three children back in 1917. So I'm looking forward to that part of the journey. But I know already Our Lady's energy is walking with me and working with me. And the journey to the Camino is a personal journey for each and every person. I'm not sure everybody takes it for spiritual reasons. I think some people do it because they think it will be fun. It doesn't really matter what your reasons are for doing it. I know for those of you watching this channel that you're looking at the spiritual journey, and maybe you're not even thinking about doing the Camino, but you're on a spiritual journey. And so these videos that I'm producing, and have to forgive the haphazard way they're put together because I'm just learning how to do it, but there is a calling in me to share this journey because I know so many of you are on a similar journey. And it's this journey of life. It's this journey back to self. It's the journey of discovery of who we are, why we do what we do, how we can just be better people. And when I say better people, I always have this thing of us finding out who we already are. So I know that we're already light, I know that we're already love, but I do know that through the journey, we've collected people on our way that have given us thoughts, beliefs and experiences that have changed the way we believe what's possible for ourselves. So I know for me personally, this is about what is possible for me. And hopefully what's possible for you. You're on a journey, whether you believe it or not. Every day is a journey of discovery and exploration. Every day you're carrying around a backpack. Every day you're carrying around things with you that you've packed, that you've kept. And even though you think sometimes you've let go of the layers, have you really? Are you really ready to let it go? I think it's just interesting to ponder and explore. And to be very mindful of each and every step that you take every day is somewhere taking you somewhere new. You may be going round and round in circles, so I think it's to look at that as well. And on this training journey, I plan to do lots of different walks, but I'm also recognizing that I have to condition myself by sometimes doing the same walk, because then my body will say, yeah, this is okay, this is safe. So far on this training journey, I've already done, I think last week I did like 120Ks, but mainly flat walking. This week I'm walking with the backpack on, walking through terrain that is not flat, and just seeing how I adjust and allowing myself to adjust. So I think wherever you are on your journey at the moment, just be patient, just be gentle. And if you are doing the Camino, make sure that you leave yourself the opportunity to train before you get there. I'll show you my walking shoes in a minute. I've had these walking shoes for about 6 months now, and I've worn them every day while I've been walking. And I wasn't really doing it because I thought I'd be doing this walk, but I just said to myself, I've got these shoes, so think about this. I've got this body, I've got this heart, I've got this life, I've got this energy, I might as well be in it. And that's what I've been doing with these shoes. So these shoes are very representative of this journey of life that we're walking. And I think for you, if you're going to do any journey like this, most important thing is, yeah, to really, really walk your shoes in. Because I can tell you now, since I decided to do the journey, I've had so many ups and downs. I had a back operation when I was 40, and I'm now 61. I had another one 5 or 6 years later, quite a big one. Before I had the second one, I thought I would never walk again. And so when I decided to do this journey, even though I go to the gym 3 or 4 times a week, I'm incredibly strong, even though I walk every day, almost every day, my body started to give me all these pains, and all my fears came up of having another back problem. My feet were hurting, everything was hurting, and I'm going, oh my God, what's going on? And I really just had to sit with it and talk to myself and talk to my body and say, it's okay, I'm going to be okay. This is just part of this journey back to self, this journey of really trusting in my own ability. Oh, look, we've got a friend in the background. See, we've got the turkey there. So it's, very interesting, isn't it, eh? So these are my trusty shoes. They're beautiful boots from Merrell. Really, really, really comfortable. Got beautiful socks, Kathmandu socks with no seams, that you can wash out every day. But I've had these for about 6 months or more. Done loads and loads and loads of walking in them. They still look brand new, but they actually fit me like a glove. So truly, whatever money you're going to spend in life, whether it's doing a walk or not, your feet are the things that hold you up. If you haven't got support, and this is for any aspect of your life, by the way, not just your shoes in life, but any aspect of your life, if you haven't got the right foundations, how can you do what you need to do each and every day? So make sure, if you're walking, you get good shoes, and make sure if you're just following this as a spiritual journey that you spend the money on what you need so that you can feel safe and secure. There's what's going to be my best friend for the next few weeks, my beautiful Dynalite North Face backpack. And it's truly, truly the most comfortable thing I've ever put on. But you know, when I started on this journey, I haven't worn a backpack ever. So I had no idea how any of it worked. I went into a bit of a meltdown, didn't know how things did up or what to do. So I got my friend, she came round and she's coming on the journey with me. So she sorted me out, showed me how it all worked. Don't we all need a friend on a journey that's going to help us? The other thing was that I did, because I was in so much doubt, I went down to a shop and I thought, well, I'll try on another backpack, see how that goes. And honestly, when I tried on the other backpacks, I nearly had another conniption, because I thought, I can't do this, they're heavy. And what they did in the shop, they put a weight in there so that they put 5 kilos in. Well, I can lift more than 5 kilos on my ear, but when I had it on my back, I went, oh, I can't do this. And all of the weight was on my lower back and it just wasn't right. So I think I spent maybe nearly 2 hours trying on different backpacks, and the beautiful girl in the shop, she was so helpful, but she showed me how everything worked. And I said to her in the end, look, I'm so sorry, I'm just not sure. So I walked away, thought about it, came home, put this one back on, because I bought this one on a whim. We made the choice to go on the trip. And then I said, my friend actually said, well, let's buy backpacks and then we're committed. And I went, okay. So we bought the backpacks. We decided on the Thursday, bought the backpacks Thursday night, booked the flight on the Friday, and that was it, done. And the shop that we went into had 2 backpacks. We both got the same backpacks. Mine's smaller because I'm a smaller person. But when I got it home, I kind of said to myself, well, what if it's the wrong one? And as intuitive as I am, I doubted it. But I had to try on all the others to know if it was the right one. So that's like life, isn't it? You've got to keep trying things on and seeing if it's right for you. And if it's not right for you, then walk away, give yourself time. And sometimes it's like going back to what you know is right for you. So anyway, me and my trusty backpack, we're going to become the best of friends, I can tell you now. One of the things I'm noticing today on my training journey is how much beauty there is around me and how much I can have the freedom to explore the here and now. Because I know the journey on the Camino is all about what will happen when I get there, but it's as much about what I'm doing now in preparation for it. And part of that preparation is exploring where I live and looking at different routes I can take each and every day. So today I'm choosing to walk from hard gravel, and I'm going to go into a place where there is, let's say, softer sand, more hills,
a little bit of shade, a little bit of light. It's a bit like our journey of life, really, a little bit of shade, a little bit of light. Are we ever fully prepared for what comes on the journey? No, we're not. So it's just about that spontaneity, being able to be in it. But let's see how the rest of the day pans out. This point on the journey, I'm thinking a lot about my reasons for walking the Camino. Why am I doing it? What is it about? And I think through this training process, I'm going to maybe have a different focus every day. Today for me, it's about love. It's about the way that I nurture and love myself. And part of that is thinking about all the things that I've carried with me in my life. Oh, I've carried doubt, I've carried fear, I've carried so many unrealistic expectations of myself. And part of this preparation today is really looking at those expectations, maybe the way I've set such high standards for myself. Now on this journey, the journey when I get to the Camino, when I get to Porto, and eventually when I get to Santiago, will I think be about just celebrating the whole of the journey. And so today it's about looking what I carry with me, how much of my fears are packed in my bag here. I've heard so many people that I've watched preparing for the journey saying that we often pack our fears. So things like maybe if you're fearful that you're going to lose a shoelace, you'll pack an extra shoelace to carry. I'm really trying not to pack my fears. One of my fears though is being cold. So I've looked for something really lightweight to carry with me that I know will keep me warm. And I guess on this preparation for the journey, we're looking for how much can you carry that is dual purpose. So what can I carry that is going to be light, and how could I use it for something else? So I'm kind of thinking this is very, very light. It might double up as a pillow. So that's a good practical thing. But if I look at, always wanting to be warm, it reminded me of something else, right? So I'm on the Gold Coast preparing. It's September, generally speaking, really, really warm. And this morning I was freezing. So I thought, well, I'm going to wear my merino that I've got for the Camino. Merino for the Camino. That's a good plug for them, isn't it? So good Australian merino wool. I've got my little puffer jacket that's going to keep me warm and not be too bulky. And I've got this thing about, what if I heat up? So if I heat up, I can take off a layer. And that's what we do in life, isn't it? We heat up when we get passionate or when we've exercised. And exercising is walking the path of life. And that when you walk the path of life, there's going to be things that happen that are never what we think they are. And sometimes we get passionate, we get angry. Sometimes we get passionate, we get excited. And then we strip a layer off. So I'm sure down the track I'll be stripping a layer off. But when we strip a layer off, one thing for me at the moment is I'll still have to carry that layer with me. And so it kind of makes me think, do we ever really get rid of our layers until we decide that we don't need them anymore? So I know many of you have done your own healing and you say, I thought I'd dealt with this. I thought I'd dealt with it. But sometimes I think we keep things because somewhere they keep us feeling safe. So yeah, interesting what realizations are coming along this amazing, beautiful amble and stroll through the beautiful path that I'm taking this morning. So what's interesting about walking with a backpack on is that people ask you, what are you in training for? Where are you going? And the first person that asked me that, when I told them what I was doing, they said, wow, that's the journey I did 3 years ago. And so we stopped, we had a massive chat, asked her all these questions, and the exact same journey. Flew into Lisbon, got the train to Porto, and then walked to Santiago, and don't know what she did after that, but for me that's open-ended at this stage, what I do afterwards. But I just thought, how incredible is that? The first person that has said to me, you're in training for something, where are you going? And when I expressed where I was going, they're on the same journey, have done the same journey. So kind of what do I get from that is that, slowly, even though we don't always think it's happening, we're getting closer and closer to our tribe, to those people who've traveled where we've traveled. Because you're watching this, you're on a similar journey to me, that journey of just discovering who you are and wanting adventure in life. So yeah, I'm just loving the way all of this is working and how I'm being shown how supported I am on the journey. So here I am halfway on the journey, a bit windswept and interesting. Halfway on my training walk today, and wow, it's been an awesome morning.
and I feel like I've walked a million miles already. It's always harder when you've got the backpack on, and you know, it's like carrying two people with you. But I'm going to walk back another way. Met some amazing people on the journey this morning. One of them was a client that I have, and we've only ever worked together on Zoom. So we both saw each other and were like, oh, is that you? And she's like, Susan, is that you? I'm like, yeah, it is. So that was kind of an amazing little chat. It was a beautiful eagle just flown above me with a fish in its claws. How amazing is that? I don't think I can capture it on video. It's flying behind me, I think. God, so many amazing things happening. It's like, wow, you just got to be out in life, don't you? You know, so I just encourage you, whatever you're doing as you're watching these, if you're not taking journeys every day and just getting out and about in your local area, then start doing it, because there's so much that you see. I normally walk really early in the morning, and for me, I think, I don't know, it's about 10 o'clock in the morning now. So I'd be, you know, in my office by now, I'd be doing readings and healings. But today I've said, no, I haven't got a client till this afternoon. Full week, but I'm going to really make the most of this time. So yeah, I encourage you to do the same thing and get out and about in your local area. I'm on the Gold Coast. It's my training walk. I've just had my first Bon Camino. So I just met a couple. They stopped on their push bikes and they said, are you training for something? I said, yeah. They go, are you doing the Camino? I bet you are. And I said, yeah, I am. Anyway, we've just had a half an hour conversation. So I don't know if I'm ever going to get home or actually get to the Camino. But oh my God, they shared so much with me. And they said, you know, it gets in your blood. And they were telling me all these things. And I'm just like, you know, husband and wife, and they did it. And they did the 1,000 kilometer one. But it's like the journey. Oh my God, it's so bloody amazing. So honest to God, I can't get over how many people have either done it or want to do it. But it's this thing of a shared and joint journey. So yeah, how's that, eh? I'm buzzing. I've only just come back from my halfway stop. So I don't know if I'm gonna do any more videos on this leg, because I wanna get to the gym and I wanna get some leg presses in. But oh my God, my heart's open, my heart's full. So I'm just feeling this amazingness of this beautiful journey and just how willing people are to share theirs. So yeah, anyway, Bon Camino. I've done the walk and now I'm gonna pump out some iron here at the gym. And hopefully that just, well, not hopefully, that's going to give me different strength in different parts of my body. So even though I've done the walking with the pack on, I had to get changed. I'm absolutely perspiring like a mad woman. So I'm going to do some leg presses. I'm going to do some arm work and just really, you know, maybe 20 minutes of overall fitness. And yeah, hope you've enjoyed watching this training video. And yeah, inspiration for me so far, what I've learned today. The biggest thing has been about meeting the people along the way that have done the journey and are sharing it with me. It's kind of like I feel really excited.